I'm a storyteller. I'm a person who shares his experiences for social emotional learning and hoping to create that conscious global awakening.
Emmanuel Jal had a pretty unusual childhood. He was just a boy during the Sudanese civil war in the 90s, when he was captured and forced to fight as a child soldier.
Let's talk about your childhood. Take us back when you were a child.
I was born in very rough time, and that was in the 80s during Sudanese civil war.
The Sudanese civil war was between Sudan's government forces and rebel fighters from the south of the country who wanted an independent South Sudan.
My father told me that I should go to school in Ethiopia. And I was excited. As a kid, I was curious. And so arriving in Ethiopia, we went to school for a while. But that's when we got trained. And that's why I became a child soldier. The training was a difficult one because they had to use force. And an example has to, because training children is like training chickens. Listening to the orders and the rules was difficult. And I remember a point where we're being trained how to attack a town, and my elbows were bruised and it was bleeding. And I didn't want to do it anymore. And there was a kid who just put his head up and didn't want to do it, he was crying. And then one man just kicked him on his skull, on the back. I didn't understand why do we jog and do press up every day, until one day those scenarios saved my life, where I had to be in a situation running for almost the whole day. And if I didn't learn how to jog, I wouldn't be here today. How I got rescued is, it was an escape we planned, where we're like between 200 to 400 young people, and only 16 people survived. A journey where we were drinking our own urine. I was eating snails to survive, and I was also tempted to eat my fellow human being. And in this journey, this is where I met a British aid worker called Emma McCune. And Emma McCune was the one who smuggled me to Kenya. But going to Kenya, Emma McCune died. And so when she died, my life became another challenge. And so that's when I began to experience what is called trauma.
So how did you heal yourself from the trauma?
It took me years. But one of the fundamental steps I did is first learning how to forgive myself for the harm I caused myself and others, and also forgiving those who have caused me harm without expecting them to ask for forgiveness.
Eventually, South Sudan gained independence from Sudan in a referendum in 2011.